Hello chaps, Harry Badger here. Today I'm going to show you how to make a full HD night vision 1080p 30 frames a second action camera for under 20 quid. Just to give you a bit of background, I've got an upcoming Halloween Airsoft night game at the Gunman Tuddenham site on the 28th of October, and by all accounts is shaping up to be an awesome and spooky night out. So for the last few weeks I've been researching the best way to do this. The options I've toyed with to get full HD video footage of the night was, firstly, I looked at the Psionics Aurora. The base version of this digital camera is nearly £600 and the pro version is just under £1,000. The plan would have been to have run it as a tactical night vision monocular, albeit a digital one. And I came close to buying one on eBay for about £800, but after a few email exchanges with the seller, who also turned out to be a airsofter, he told me very honestly that it was rubbish for night games and I would be better off saving my money for a proper Gen 2 or a Gen 3 night vision rig. However, these Gen 2, Gen 3 night vision rigs don't provide the ability to record video footage. So it was back to the drawing board. My search continued and all I could find were the noddy digital cameras, and most of them had a low resolution such as 640 or 720 pixels. But then by chance, and don't ask me how, I stumbled upon some paranormal and ghost hunting YouTube videos showing how to convert a GoPro to a night vision camera. From my research, I discovered that the light sensor in the GoPro Hero 3 and 4 can actually pick up the infrared light spectrum. However, there is a filter that's built into the lens that blocks this infrared light. Ghost hunters simply swap out the lens altogether, albeit that they're glued in. But doing this will render the GoPro near useless for daytime recording. So rather than destroying my own GoPro, the great news is that there are plenty of GoPro knockoffs, which are cheap but have the same infrared capable sensor built in. The additional benefit of these knockoffs is that the IR filter can easily be removed from the lens. These include the SJ Cam SJ 4000 for around about 60 to 70 quid and the Vermont 1080p. Amazingly, I found the Vermont camera on Amazon for $17.99, so I took a punt and snapped one up. Worst case is I break a cheap camera and it's no great loss if things go wrong. So today I'm going to show you how to do this for Airsoft and on a budget. So here is the Vermont 1080 and here is the GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition. I'm not going to mess around with my GoPro, so I'll put that safely to one side. The first thing to do is take the battery out. And then it will give you access to be able to pop off the front cover. I'm using a plastic tool, which is a prizing tool, which I had left over from an old mobile phone repair kit. Take a small Phillips screwdriver and undo the four screws in each corner. I then used some tweezers to remove the screws as they were self-tapping and a little bit tricky to get out. You can gently, and most importantly, only partially remove the camera innards from the housing. Do not yank them out completely. The internal circuit board is still attached to the LCD screen with a little ribbon cable. What you'll need to do is to carefully pop your finger into the space where the battery used to be and create a little gap, allowing you to put your prizing tool under the LCD cover. There is a front plastic cover protecting the LCD screen, which needs to come off. Just run your plastic prizing tool around the edge of the cover to remove it. This will reveal the LCD screen. The LCD screen can be released from the housing by just lifting up the LCD at the ribbon cable end. Turn the LCD to a slight angle and then it will fit through the housing and the complete camera gubbins will just simply drop through. Pop up the catch on the top of the ribbon cable on the circuit board and the LCD will detach. You can put this to one side for now. We need to remove the circuit board from the housing, and there are just two screws to do this. Flip it over and remove the surround for the lens. There are just three fixing points for this, which are just clipped into the housing, and these are top, bottom, and right. The front section, which houses the battery, can be folded away from the lens. So this is the lens that we need access to in order to remove that IR filter. Do not, I repeat, do not attempt to unscrew the lens just yet. This lens is held in place by some glue on the thread. If you turn it over, you will see where there are supposed to be two little screws that hold the lens unit to the circuit board. But these are missing on the two cameras I have opened up so far, and the lens unit itself is only tacked onto the circuit board with some tape or some low adhesive glue. I found a couple of tiny self-tapping screws from another project, and I just simply screwed them in. This now securely holds the lens unit to the circuit board. I didn't notice these missing screws on the first camera I'd worked on, and I ended up ripping the ribbon cable, so I had to start from scratch on another camera, and thank God I didn't do this on my GoPro. The next thing to do is to take either a hairdryer, or in my case a hot air soldering station, and gently warm up the glue that's on the lens thread. It doesn't take much to soften up the glue, and you can gently unscrew the lens. Please don't force it, and you won't need a pair of pliers like I've seen in other how-to videos. By hand, the lens should break the seal with the glue, and then you can completely remove the lens. This is the lens with the IR filter. You may find a blob of glue still attached to either the lens thread or the lens unit, and you can simply remove this. Now that the lens is out, it's time to remove that IR filter. Take the hairdryer or the hot air gun again and gently warm up the bottom of the lens. There's some glue holding in this little IR filter retainer. With the glue softened, ease out the bottom piece gently. You may have to warm it up a couple of times before it will come completely out. And there's the IR filter, it's that little square piece of glass inside the lens. On the original GoPro, as I mentioned, this filter is actually integrated into the lens itself. Take some fine tweezers and lift it, and then you'll be able to get it out. It's in there loose, so it shouldn't be difficult. Now it's time to put everything back together. I'm starting with pushing the IR filter retainer back into the bottom of the lens and then screwing the lens back into the lens unit. The camera goes back in the reverse order of what we did to take it apart. It should now all be back together, apart from the lens surround and the front cover. We still need these off for the time being. Time to put the battery back in and see if the camera powers up. Press the power button on the front of the camera and you'll see initially a blue indicator light followed by the Vermont logo. The logo will disappear after a second and then you will see a blurry image. This is to be expected for now. You can also put in an SD card, anything up to a maximum of 32 gig will do. The last thing we need to do is to refocus the lens. The lens focus is simply based on how far the lens is screwed into the lens unit. We need to screw it in to the right distance for the lens to be in focus. On a GoPro, you can attach the camera to either a TV or a computer with an appropriate cable and focus it that way. But on the Vermont camera, you don't have the option of being able to see a live feed on a big screen. And the small screen, well, it's tricky to use when focusing unless you've got super good eyesight. My workaround was to get the lens screwed in to roughly in focus. Then I've got a little white fine marker, but you can use a pencil. and I made some little markings on the inner housing and then one on the lens. With the SD card in, I started recording and saying, this is center, this is one notch up, this is two notches up, and so on, and then back to the center. And this is one notch down, two notches down, and so on. I kind of used it to dial in the focus. Then I played the video back on a computer with a big screen, and for me, well, I found it was just under one notch down. That was the sweet spot for the focus. You've probably noticed and are wondering why the Vermont camera footage is pink. In daylight, without the IR filter, it will be pink, but the sole purpose of this camera for me is only for night recording. Now I can put the lens surround and the front cover back on. That's it, we're all done. Congratulations, you've now got yourself a night vision high definition action camera. Well, almost. One last thing that we'll need is an infrared torch, and you may have one of these already. I've mounted the modified camera and IR torch to my Fast helmet with the standard fittings. I wanted to compare the Vermont footage to the GoPro 3. So I made up a little rig on a Picatinny rail for both cameras. There's a little clump of woods in the area near me, and at this time of the evening it was just starting to get dark. So here's some video footage of both the GoPro original, which is completely untouched, and beside it I've got the new Vermont modified version with the IR filter removed, and just got them side by side, and here's the footage with the infrared torch on, and you can see on the GoPro can hardly see anything, so using a normal action camera to try and record a night game is completely useless, really. Of course, if I had night vision, you'd clearly see who and where I am, because I'm waving this big infrared torch around. The IR torch that I have gives off a focused beam, and I wish I could get it wider to fill up the whole video frame. I'm looking for some options and various different illuminators, but probably not in time to share for the results of this video. We'll have to experiment. So I think with this setup, I think I'm pretty happy with it. The tests will be on the 28th for the Halloween game. It'll be interesting to see how the tracer unit and illuminated BBs come out. I hope this has been useful, and if you do want to record a night game, then maybe try out this modification on a cheap camera rather than destroying an original GoPro. Maybe you found some alternative to be able to record night games in HD. Please leave a comment in the section below. So thanks for watching, and this is Harry Badger signing off.